God. Hallelujah. Come on and bless him. Bless him. Clap those hands and love him. Father God, we thank you today. We love you. We worship you. We adore you. We bless you. We thank you for the spirit that is already in this house, and we give your name great praise for what you've already done and what you're going to do. There is a word in this house from the peep from God, and I believe that the people of the Lord will be blessed. I need him. I feel the power of God already. It's already locked in this building. Hallelujah. I thank God for the Word Network. I thank God for Lady Lexi. I thank God for my own husband, Minister Eugene Nichols Jr. I'm just honored to be here. Bishop Ellis, I love you. And how many of you need him today? How many of you need him? Hallelujah. I need thee, oh, I need thee. We bless him. From the book of St. Mark, I want to talk to you today. Feel the power of God already in my sanctified soul. Mark the 16th chapter. One verse into your hearing. Scripture reads, but go your way. Tell his disciples and Peter that he goeth before you into Galilee. There ye shall see him as he said unto you. I want to lift my thought from the words, go and tell his disciples and Peter. I want you to know today that Jesus wants to meet you. Jesus wants to meet you. Let me talk about this particular passage of scripture. The events leading up to this passage will depict the death, the burial, and the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We read these events in all of the synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke. It is in these gospels that we learn of several events which occur in the life of Jesus before his crucifixion, from the Last Supper with his disciples to the confession of Peter that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. We see in these gospels where Peter declares that he would never deny Jesus. If you read it, you'll find that Jesus says, everyone may be offended by me and leave me, but it is Peter who stands up. Anybody know about Peter? Rambunctious Peter, He stands up and says, oh, no, no, I will never leave you. He says, I'll never do it. Jesus, being omniscient, knowing all things, says, listen, Peter, before the rooster crows three times, you are going to deny me. But Peter doesn't understand what's going on. He again blatantly refuses, no, I will never leave you. I want to park there for a moment because I've learned to never say never. You never know what you do. You never know what you'd say. You never know what's going to happen until it happens. You've got to be in a place with God till you say, it is by his mercy that we are not consumed. I'm finding out that so many times we're set on condemning and talking about others and saying who shouldn't have done this and who wouldn't have done this and what I would have done differently. But you've got to get to a place to where you work on your own self. The William brother said, sweep around your own front door before you try to sweep around mine. Peter says, oh, I'm never ever going to deny you. Makes a promise that he can't even keep. But Jesus sees and he knows. Now, I want you to understand here that as Jesus is preparing for the redemptive power, he knows that he must drink of a bitter cup. He knows that this cup will consist of all of our our sins. We find now, and you can read it, that Jesus is in the Garden of Gethsemane. He is betrayed by Judas with a kiss. And we find the soldiers come to take Jesus away. But Peter, keep your mind on Peter, the rambunctious one, takes his sword out and chops the ear of the soldier off. Yes, yes, he does. But Jesus, knowing in his infinite wisdom what he needs to do and knowing his purpose, he picks the ear up and puts it back on the soldier's ear. And basically he says, go ahead and do what you got to do. I know what I've been called here for. I know what my purpose is. I know what I've got to do. Go ahead and do what you need to do. Can you imagine Peter now seeing his Lord and Savior? Oh, what's going on? What's going on? Why in the world is he allowing them to take him away? Why in the world is this happening? Peter is following from afar off. Jesus is tried in an unjust courtroom. We find that Jesus is convicted and he is crucified. It is at Calvary that Jesus is beaten and he is whipped. He's spat upon. He's talked about. He's ostracized. He's criticized. But he does it because he knows that he has to redeem the world. Look at Peter. Let me go back to Peter now. Peter is following from afar off and someone notices him. Look, Peter, aren't you the one that's been walking with Jesus? You look just like one of them. Aren't you the one that's been with him? Aren't you the one that ate with him? Aren't you the one that was with him when he did miracles? Peter, he steps back and he begins to deny Jesus. He says, I know not the man. I don't know who he is. Not only does he deny, but he begins to curse and he begins to refute the fact that he knows who Jesus is. When the chips got down, Peter stepped back. But look at what happens here. Once he denied, the Bible would have us to know that the rooster crowed. He heard him three times and Peter remembered. Peter remembered. Go back now. Jesus is crucified. Let me take you back there to the sepulchre. The girls go to find the body of Jesus and to wrap it up with expensive oils. But instead of finding Jesus, they find an angel. The angel says to them, you're looking for Jesus, but he is not here. He has risen just like he said he would do. And he gives the instruction, listen, what I want you to do is go to the disciples and Peter and tell them to meet me in Galilee. Jesus says, go get the disciples. But I particularly like how he includes Peter, even though Peter denied, even though Peter lied, even though Peter said he wasn't going to do it and made a promise but couldn't keep it. Jesus still says, go and get my disciples and Peter. Can you imagine what Peter is thinking now when the girls come and tell him Jesus is about to show up? He's getting ready to meet you. Peter is at a place to where he has denied Jesus. He has said he didn't want to have anything to do with him. He didn't know who he was. But Jesus still says, go and get my disciples and Peter and tell him that I want him to meet me. In other words, Jesus says, even though I know what you did, even though I know you denied, even though I know you said you didn't know me and acted like you didn't love me, I have been to the cross and I'm all risen again and I've got power, Peter. I want you to come on and meet me. Jesus says, tell my disciples and Peter. Do I have anybody that understand what I'm meaning here? You got some Peters in the house that you know who Jesus was. You've been in relationship with him. You supped with him. You heard grandmama talk about him. You heard that mama said he was good. He was a good God. You heard him healed. You heard that he delivered. And you heard that he set free. And all of a sudden, when you went through in your mind, you went through in your family, you went through on your job, you stepped back and denied Jesus.
You said, I know not the man. I don't want to have nothing to do with him. I don't want to pray no more. I don't want to go to church no more. I don't want to fast no more. Because I don't understand what's going on. But I want you to know that Jesus says, I'm looking for you. Come on and meet me. Because it is finished. He has risen with all power. Come on and meet me. Bring your problems. Bring your troubles. Bring your trials. Bring your situations. And meet me. Because he wants to deliver. He wants to heal you. He wants to take you up a little bit higher. Above your problems. High above your troubles. Jesus wants to meet you. Jesus wants to touch you. Jesus wants to heal you. Jesus wants to deliver you. Because eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of men the things that God has in store for you. He's waiting for you. He's waiting for you. He wants to deliver you. He wants to heal you. He wants to touch you. You don't have to cry no more. You don't have to worry no more. But the Bible says, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Because I hear the Bible saying, he that shall come, he will come. He's here to deliver. He wants to meet you. He wants to heal you. He wants to set you free. He wants to bring you out and take you up a little higher. Above your troubles, above your trials. Come on and meet him. Come on and meet him. I know he's all right. Come on and clap your hands and give God a praise today. Jesus wants to meet you right where you are. Put your hands together and give him the best praise that you can. I don't care what you've done. I don't care who you are. I don't care where you've been. He got up with all power. He wants to meet you. He wants to heal you. He wants to bring you through. It's time for breakout. It's time for breakthrough. It's time for deliverance. Clap your hands and give him praise. Jesus wants to meet you. Jesus.